Hey YouTube, how you guys doing? My name is Kyle, you know me as Dragonmar, and welcome to a new video. Today guys, we'll be going over 10 tips and tricks to perfect your economy usage in Valorant. Some of these tips will include the keys to winning eco rounds, what not to do, and when and what to buy in what rounds. I'm going to teach you guys a few of my little secrets, some things that have helped me a lot along the way in my ranked games. But with that being said, the gameplay you're seeing in this video is from my live stream on Twitch. We just became an affiliate. We got a sub button and now we're on the path to partner. So thank you so much for the support. I hope you guys stop by. We stream every Tuesday and Thursday at 6 p.m. Eastern and Saturdays at 11 a.m. Eastern. And occasionally on Sunday, like maybe even today, if this video goes out, maybe you'll see it on Sunday. As well as the Twitch, there's also Twitter and Discord links down below. Hope to see you guys there. If not, well, I hope you enjoy this video. All right, guys, jumping into tip number one, we have pistol round success. So winning a pistol round is super important to getting a little head start on your economy. Going down round one can sometimes be a disaster depending on what rounds follow it up. So I want to give you some of my tips here to sort of win these pistol rounds. Now, first things first, pistol round, you should always be buying a ghost with utility if you're a support player or you're a player who's not going to be taking that entry frag role. If you're someone who likes to fight at long range, highly recommend you take the ghost. If not, the classic with armor is a great option for entry fraggers. It gives you that headshot protection close range and can sometimes be the difference between you taking a sight and you dying on the very first shot. With that being said though, if you are playing a Sage, I also would recommend getting a classic with utility. The wall and the slows alone are going to be very expensive on Sage, so with that, she wouldn't actually get armor. Now, pistol round is super important, but knowing what to buy in a pistol round is super important, so I want to just make something very clear. Do not buy a sheriff on the pistol round. I repeat, do not buy a sheriff on the pistol round. All right, tip number two is following that up with what to do on the second round after you win the pistol round. So you're probably wondering, you're right, all right, so what do I buy? Do I buy an SMG? Do I buy a Vandal if I can? Well, I'm here to tell you that I actually now am recommending people to stick with a ghost with full armor for the second round. You also want to grab utility. I always think it's important to grab utility when you can, because you can save it between rounds as well. But I used to say to always buy an SMG. I think what I've realized is that because of the way second rounds generally get played out, especially after winning the first one, I actually find there's now way more value to stick with those ghosts. However, if you have a classic, I actually do recommend probably upgrading to at least a Stinger in most situations. I think that it's important that at least maybe one player has some sort of upgraded SMG. But overall, the goal of the second round is to use as little money as possible and still win that round. The good thing about using as little money possible, which means it means you can buy on the third round no matter what. So that's another really important part here, is that instead of buying on the third round with a mixed buy with SMGs and Vandals and Phantoms, now you're going to buy on that third round all across the board, full armor with your preferred rifle. All right, so my third tip here is just one that I feel like it needs to be addressed. It's to never buy a rifle in the second round. So if you win the first round, pistol round, you might be able to afford a rifle. You should not buy a rifle, and I'm going to explain why very, very simply. There is a much higher chance the enemy team wins that round if they kill you than with any other gun you could have bought in that round. Any SMG, pistol, whatever, shotgun. The problem with buying a rifle in the second round is you put a target on your back. You're putting into the enemy's heads, if we kill this player, we get this Vandal, we get this Phantom, they might be able to turn that round around and win, because now they're going to outgun every single other player on your team. So it's really important here to not be selfish and to understand that yes, you might be able to get a few more kills during that round with a rifle, but you should not buy it because the risk far outweighs any sort of reward. The reward is purely selfish if you buy a rifle on the second round. All right, so now we have tip number four, and this is one of my favorites. It's the shorty, and the shorty is the key to winning eco rounds, a lot of them at least, especially round two and even sometimes deeper into the game. Now, what's so good about the shorty is that for 200 credits, you're essentially getting one kill. No matter what, it's really, really easy to use. All it requires is to just be close to the enemies. So with this being said, you want to think about where you're playing. If you're playing on a site, you can't ever expose yourself to enemy team. You have to play behind boxes. What I like to do is I like to sit very close around corners, around entrances. So playing like in sewers or short A. I love playing in garage towards C on Haven. I was also talking about Haven for the last one. On Bind, I just sit in U-Haul. Things like that. You really, really got to be close. But the shorty is such a huge aspect now of my every game sort of play. It's something that I sort of didn't think about very much in the first month or so of playing the game. I was like, oh, this is a crappy pistol. I can't shoot at range. Why would I ever use it? Well, the answer is, yeah, you can't shoot at range because you're only going to go for those close range kills. Yes, you're going to lose some rounds because you can't shoot at long range, but you're going to win so many more because you are going to kill that player with a rifle, with your shorty. You're going to grab it, and then you're going to win the round by killing the team. Trust me. Trust me. The shorty is the key right now to winning eco rounds. You stay close range, you win the round. Now, one of the most important ways to keep your economy nice and high and to sort of make sure that your team is doing the best they can and no one's dying for nothing is to trade kills and to work with your team. So, eco rounds really are only won with teamwork. And what I mean by this is if you don't know what an eco round is essentially any round where you're going to save and where you're not fully buying weapons and armor. So you're most likely on like classics or ghosts or maybe a few of you have SMGs. That's an eco round. So how do you win these? Because these are super important, right? This is a big part of the economy is how many enemies can you kill in this round, first of all, because you want to hurt their economy. But on top of that, it's also about how, you know, likely are you to actually win? Can you win this round? And there's one really easy way. I know I say easy, but there's one way to greatly increase your odds of winning a round, and that is, of course, with trading kills. So what I mean by trading kills is that you and your team, when you are entering a site or taking a fight, one of you is going to peek. They might die, and then you have another player peek immediately after or during that fight to trade out that kill, to get the kill on the enemy. The problem with eco rounds is that a lot of people play way too selfishly and they play on their own. You still have to stick together to some degree so you can help each other. It's really, really important because you have to understand, you're all going to be outgunned. So you want a 2v1 every situation possible to give yourself the best chance at winning that round. What ends up happening is once you trade out that kill, yes, you traded one death for one death. You're like, okay, Kyle, that's not very good. It's still an even game. Well, you're wrong because now you can pick up that weapon that the enemy dropped, hopefully, and suddenly you have an even better chance of winning that round because now you probably have a rifle. Really, really important on eco rounds in particular, guys, that you are trading out your kills and working with your team. If it means you have to throw your life away to get a kill, that's worth it. So you got to stop being selfish. All right. Now, tip number 6 is that on rounds that feel impossible, so anything like a 1v5 or a 1v4 situation, you're going to want to save. Or if you're not going to save, you want to go for exit frags, that's fine as well. So let's talk about the difference, right? It's really important that you guys understand that your economy is built up every round. It's not like it's just independent on each round. It builds over the course of a game. So what you save in one round will always carry over to that next round, obviously, unless the half changes. So keeping that in mind, you can understand how important it is to save weapons and not just throw away your life. So with that being said, when it comes to saving, essentially your goal is to just get out of that round alive and keep your weapon. However, if you are someone who likes to go for a little more aggressive of a playstyle, you can go for what's called exit frags. Now, exit frags is when you look for enemies who are exiting a bomb site or just running out of an area and you kill them. And the point here is that either you're trying to get their weapon or at the same time, you're just going for kills. In that case, you want to hurt their economy. So remember, every kill you get is new armor and new weapons the enemy team has to buy for that player or that player has to buy for themselves. So that's at least 3,900 credits there that are gone for that enemy team. It's really important that you remember that this applies to you as well. So it's really important to understand the value of saving versus the value of going for these exit frags and just staying alive. Super, super important not to throw your life away because that's how you get into bad economic situations. Tip number 7 is to never max out on your money and to make sure you're buying for your teammates. So momentum is super big in Valorant and sometimes your economy can really start building up quickly. So what you'll want to do in these situations is you want to make sure you're checking your money, making sure you're never getting up to that max credits. If you do get close to max, sometimes maybe if you're carrying, doing really well, it's actually pretty easy to get to 9K. So what you want to do is you want to make sure you're buying for your team. And this doesn't just go for max money either. This can go on any sort of round, any round where you're doing pretty well. Your team might not always be doing as well as you. And what's really important here to understand is that your weakest link So the player with nothing can sometimes be your downfall. So it's really important to understand that that player on C site with an SMG may be the one who's going to lose you that round because the enemy team takes advantage of that. That's why you buy your teammates weapons. You don't buy it because you like them or because you feel bad for them or whatever it may be. You buy it to make sure that there is an even playing field when that enemy team attacks them. You don't want any of your teammates feeling like they don't have a good enough weapon to suit the needs for that round. Every gun round, your team should all have rifles, right? Don't be selfish. Make sure you're buying for your team. All right, now tip number 8 is to upgrade based on the enemy economy. So what this means is that, and we've talked about this plenty of times, it's super important to pay attention to what the enemy has during that round. If an enemy team has less than 3,300 credits, that means that none of them can buy armor and a weapon, even the light armor. They have under 39, they can't buy full armor and a rifle. So you have to keep that in mind. That can play a big role in what you buy during that round and what you risk during that round. If all of your team has rifles except for you, and you're going to a round where the enemy team is probably saving, it's totally fine to just buy something like a Stinger, stick with a Ghost, or whatever you want if you feel like you couldn't buy full utility armor and a rifle that round. You're kind of saving for next round in a way. It's totally fine to do that, and you should only upgrade based on the enemy economy. It's really important that you understand that you don't want to be wasting money as much as possible, but you also want to give yourself the highest chance of winning a round. So pay attention to what your team has, what the enemy team has, and it's always good to check out that scoreboard before a round starts. You know, gauge what's going on, make sure, hey, you know, do they have ops? What do they have? What sort of utility will we need? Things like that. Highly recommend you always check what the enemy team has before the round starts to sort of base your purchasing decisions on. Tip number 9. Oh, you guys guessed it. It's to play as a team, right? It's to save as a team, force as a team, and buy as a team. Obviously, when you're saving, it means your entire team is going to save that round. No one's buying. If you're forcing as a team, it means your entire team is going to force up weapons. They're going to buy whatever they can, the best they can, use all of their money to win that round. And if you're buying as a team, it means every single person is going to be buying whatever they can, rifles, ops, whatever it may be during that round. Really, really important in Valorant to play every single round the best you can as a team and also be a team player. You know, teamwork is really what makes this game so special and what makes it like hell. So super important that everyone here understands that if your team is forcing, you are not helping the team win by saving that round because you want to op next round. You need to play the rounds that you're in and you need to play them with your team. Don't be the odd man out ever. Even if you know your teammates are wrong, it's sometimes better to be wrong and win the round than to be wrong, be selfish, and lose the round, if that makes sense. So play as a team, buy as a team. And finally, we get on to one of my favorite tips, and that is how to do a light buy. So light buys are done when you do not have enough money on that particular round to buy every player up to the full utility, full armor, and a rifle or an op. But you have enough money to get most players on like SMGs, maybe a few on rifles with some armor and utility. However, the point of a light buy is to not force. You're not forcing on a light buy. You're saving still for the next round while purchasing weapons. So essentially what you're doing is you're buying the best equipment you can for that round while making sure on the next round you have enough money. So at least 3,900, preferably more like 4,400 credits so that on the next round you can purchase full armor, full, you know, weapons and utility. Now light buys are really good because sometimes you can really pull the enemy team, you can catch the enemy team off guard because they're going to look at your economy and be like, no way, they're buying this round. You do a light buy, you get everyone some decent guns, you might win the round. But regardless, what's cool about light buys as well is it gives a great opportunity to punish the enemy team's economy by getting those kills because you'll have some good guns. And on top of that, you're still going to be able to buy next round. So it's really, really important to understand that sometimes it's really important that you do actually purchase some weapons on these sort of save rounds. But light buys are a great alternative to that. A lot of light buys end up being light armor Stingers. Sometimes you'll do full armor Spectres or maybe even, you know, like a light armor with a Marshall or something. There's some really interesting light buys that can be done. But regardless, it's important to understand how they work and why they work. And the whole point of light buy is, yes, you're trying to win the round, but really you want to do as much damage to the enemy economy as possible. All right, guys, and I think that is where we are going to end our video on how to perfect your economy usage in Valorant. So I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope these tips were helpful. Obviously, there's so much more that we could talk about the economy. So as always, if you guys have questions, please leave them down in the comments below. Make sure you guys are in the Discord. Make sure you're following me on Twitter. And of course, checking out the streams. We are streaming pretty regularly, so I hope to see you guys there. With that being said, thank you so much for being here. Thank you so much for watching. Remember to leave a like, comment, and subscribe. As always, the support has been crazy lately. So thank you so much, guys. Have a wonderful day, and I'll see you next time. Take it easy, and peace. Wow.